Good morning, children. Myself, Mrs. Ruma Putran, an educator of maths, standard 10th from Srimati L.P. Savani Vidya Bhavan. Children, today we are going to start with chapter number 5, that is arithmetic progression. Now, children, this you are learning for the first time arithmetic progression. Its short form is AP. That means AP means arithmetic progression. Now, what is meant by an arithmetic progression? It is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term except the first term. As for example, suppose if first term is 2, fixed number is added. If 3 is added to 2, so it will become 2 plus 3, 5. Now again fixed number is added, 5 plus 3 is 8. So like this, to each term fixed number is added. The list of numbers so obtained is known as arithmetic progression. Now the fixed number, whatever fixed number we are adding, that fixed number is called the common difference of the AP. Fixed number added is called common difference of the AP and its symbol is D. The fixed number, whatever fixed number we are adding, that can be positive, negative or zero. That means difference can be positive also, negative also and zero also. As for example, suppose we form the AP. AP means arithmetic progression, means list of numbers. So first term in the list of number, it is symbolized as A1. Either we can say A1 or we can say A. Second term, it is known as A2. Second term means A2. It is symbolized as A1. As I told you, in previous term, common difference, common number is added, means difference is added. So A2 is equals to A1 plus D. A3 means A2 plus D. And A4 means A3 plus D. Children, can you see? Difference, same number, common number is added to the previous term and it forms the AP. So like this we can find out first term, second term, third term and fourth term. Like this we can form the AP. Now children, next, types of AP. There are two types of AP, finite AP and infinite AP. Now children, suppose if I say first term is 3, common difference is 2. So in this 3, if 2 is added, it will become 5. Again 2 is added, 5 plus 2, 7. Again 7, 2 is added, it is 9. So here you can see it ends. Only 4 numbers are there. It is said to be finite AP. Okay, suppose if I say first 10 natural number, so that is finite. Okay, if I say all the natural numbers, means it is an infinite AP. So like this, which the number which goes on and on is said to be infinite AP. Now, today we are going to start with exercise 5.1. Now in this question, the question is, in which of the following situation does the list of numbers involved make an arithmetic progression and why? That means first of all we have to form the arithmetic progression and then we have to check whether it is an arithmetic progression or not. Now first of all we are going to form the list of numbers. They have given, the question is, the taxi fare after each kilometer when the fare is rupees 15 for the first kilometer. Rupees 15 for the first kilometer, that means A1, first kilometer A1 is equals to 15. And rupees 8 is added to each additional kilometer. For each kilometer, rupees 8 is added. So rupees 8 is added everywhere, each kilometer rupees 8 is added, means difference is 8. Now we are going to find, form an AP. A1 means first term, first kilometer it is 15. A2, just now I have shown you the formula. A2 is equals to A1 plus D. A1 is 15. Difference is 8. So 15 plus 8 is equals to 23. A3 means third term is equals to A2 plus D. A2 plus D, A2 is 23. Difference is 8. So 23 plus 8 is 31. A4 is equals to A3 plus D. 31, A3 is 31. Difference is 8. So 31 plus 8 is equals to 39. So children, can you see here difference? That means we have formed the AP. What it is? 15. 23, 31, dot dot dot, because how many kilometers it is not specified, so we have written dot dot dot. Now we have to check whether it is an AP or not. Now if we want to check whether it is an AP or not, what we have to do, we have to find out difference. The formula to find out difference is equals to A2 minus A1, 23 minus 15, 8. A3 minus A2, difference is 8. So can you see children, as difference is same, we can say, therefore we can say that it is an AP. So in this question we have to form AP. So first of all we have formed AP, then we have to check whether it is an AP or not. How we can check AP or not? By finding out the difference. Difference should be same. Now next question. Now children, as you all know here, what we have to show, we have to show, first of all, we have to form list of numbers, and then we have to check whether it is an AP or not. Now, second question, the amount of air present in a cylinder when a vacuum pump removes 1/4 of the air remaining in the cylinder at a time. Now, as for example, how much air is present in the cylinder, it is not specified. So we will write, let amount of air present in cylinder equals to x. 1/4 of the air is removed. That means first number is A1 equals to x. From this, whatever air is present in the cylinder, from that 1/4 of the air is removed, it is x. From that 1/4 of x is removed, means x minus 1/4 of x. By taking LCM, you will get 3x upon 4. That means second term is 3x upon 4. Now 3x upon 4 is there, already there. From that 1/4 of 3x upon 4 is removed, 1/4 part is removed every time. So 1/4 of 3x upon 4 is removed. So it will be 3x upon 4 minus 3x upon 4, 4s are 16. After taking LCM 16, you will get the answer 9x upon 16. So our list of numbers is x, that means first term is x, second term is 3x upon 4, third term is 9x upon 16. That means list of numbers is x, 3x upon 4, 9x upon 16, comma, dot, dot, dot. Now we have to, this we have formed the list of numbers. Now we have to check whether it is an AP or not. As I have already told you that we have to find out difference. If difference is same, then we can say that it forms an AP. If difference is not same, then we can say that it is not an AP. Now here difference, A2 minus A1 means second term minus first term. Second term is 3x upon 4 minus first term is x upon 1. Taking LCM, 1, 3s are 3, minus 4 into x, 4x. 3x minus 4x is equals to minus x upon 4. That means difference we have got minus x upon 4. Then second difference we'll find out, A3 minus A2. A3 is 9x upon 16, A2 is 3x upon 4. By taking LCM, you will get 9x minus 12x upon 16 is equals to minus 3x upon 16. Children, can you see your difference, this difference and this difference? This is not same, they are not same. So we can say that A2 minus A1 is not equals to A3 minus A2. As difference is not same, therefore it does not form an AP. So that is question number 2. Now question number 3 and 4, in the same way you can solve it by your own. Now we will start with question number 2. Yes, now question number 2 is, write first 4 terms of the AP when the first term A and the common difference D are given as follow. That means first term A is equals to 10 and difference D is equals to 10. What we have to form? We have to write first 4 terms of the AP. Now children, you know, first 4 terms means A1, A2, A3 and A4. Now A means A1 only. So A1 is equals to A is equals to 10. Formula to find out A2 is A1 plus D. That is 10 plus, difference is also 10. So 10 plus 10 is equals to 20. A3 is equals to A2 plus D. A2 is 20. Difference is 10, so 20 plus 10 is equals to 30. A4 is equals to A3 plus D. A3 is 30 plus difference is 10, so answer is 40. So children, here you can see A1, A2, A3, A4. That means first 4 terms of the AP. That means AP is equals to 10, 20, 30, 40. Now in this question 2 only, second question. First term A is equals to minus 2. Difference D is equals to 0. First term A1 is equals to A is equals to minus 2. Now we have to find out A2. A2 is equals to A1 plus D. A1 is minus 2 plus difference D is equals to 0 is equals to minus 2. A3 formula is A2 plus D. A2 is minus 2 plus difference is 0 is equals to minus 2. A4. A4 is equals to A3 plus D. A3 is minus 2 plus difference is 0. Minus 2 plus 0 is minus 2. So children, can you see here AP? All the 4 terms are same. We can get all the 4 terms same because difference, as I told you, difference can be positive, difference is 0. As difference is 0, so all the terms we got the same. Now third question, A is equals to 4, D is equals to minus 3. A means A1 is equals to A is equals to 4. A2 is equals to A1 plus D, that is A1 is 4 plus D is minus 3. Plus minus minus, so it is 4 minus 3 is equals to 1. Now A3. A3 is equals to A2 plus D. A2 is 1, difference is minus 3. So it is 1 plus minus 3. That is 1 minus 3 is equals to minus 2. Next is A4, that is 4th term. A3 plus D, A3 is minus 2 plus difference is minus 3. Minus 2 minus 3, it is minus 5. So first term is 4, second term is 1, third term is minus 2 and fourth term is minus 5. So this forms our AP. Now question number 4. First term A is given minus 1, difference D is equals to 1 by 2. Now children, you know A1 is equals to, first term A1 is equals to A is equals to minus 1. Formula for A2 is A1 plus D. A1 is minus 1 plus difference is half. Minus plus minus. If we subtract half from 1, we will get half. Sign of greater number. So it will be minus 1 by 2. A3 is equals to A2 plus D. A2 is minus 1 by 2 plus difference is 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 0. Now A4. A4 is equals to A3 plus D. A3 is 0. Difference is half. 0 plus half is half. So 4 terms of the AP are minus 1, minus 1 by 2, 0 and 1 by 2. Now question number 5. A is equals to minus 1.25, D is equals to minus 0.25. So A1 is equals to A is equals to minus 1.25. A2 is equals to A1 plus D. A1 is minus 1.25 plus difference is minus 0.25. Plus minus minus. So it will be minus 1.25 minus 0.25. Minus minus plus. So answer will be 1.50, sign of greater number, so it will be minus 1.50. Now third term is equal to second term plus difference. Second term is minus 1.50 plus difference is minus 0.25. So it will be minus 1.50 minus 0.25. Again minus minus plus, sign of greater number, so answer you will get minus 1.75. Fourth term, that is third term plus difference. Third term is minus 1.75 plus difference is minus 0.25. So it will be minus 1.75 minus 0.25. Again minus minus plus, sign of greater number. Answer you will get 2.00. 2.00 means 2. That means four terms of the AP are minus 1.25, minus 1.50, minus 1.75 and minus 2.